Hey there, superstars. It is Vanessa here again, your speaker, trainer, and coach from Live, Love, Give. And today I'm coming to you after I've just heard about a massive tragedy that's happened here in Melbourne. And actually, I hate to say it, it's connected to my hometown here in Greensboro. And I am not somebody who is, you know, constantly on the news. I oftentimes don't know what the hell is going on. But my dear beautiful mum is really good at being on top of like all the latest and things, and so I kind of like rely on her to kind of see what's going on in the world. And she was really depressed as I just kind of picked up the phone to her and I said, "Why, what's going on? What's wrong?" And she just told me about a young woman here in Melbourne who was an exchange student from Israel, who actually was brutally raped and murdered just overnight, and found very early this morning. And it was a really horrific story, and the details of which, like, I don't totally know. They haven't actually really put out fully, but it sounds really bad. And, you know, this woman, she went to a comedy night with her friends, and she, you know, she got on a tram and she came back home to her place in Bundoora, which is just around the corner from where I live. And she was attacked by a young guy who, raped and murdered her. And she was even on a FaceTime video with her sister, who is, you know, completely traumatized because she obviously heard the whole everything that went on. And anyway, why I wanted to talk about this horrific situation, which is a big dose of depression, I realize, and not something I normally would be talking about, but why I feel like it's really valuable and important is, I mean, I think it's a conversation we all need to have. And unfortunately, you know, this particular woman, you know, this young woman, she actually had the opportunity to either choose to come and be an exchange student in New York City or here in Melbourne. And she decided to choose Melbourne because she thought it would be a safer city. And now look what's happened to her. And, you know, it's why I wanted to talk into this concept today, which is to use your defenses in the correct context and know when to make yourself intelligently safe, and when to be intelligently open. And I'm gonna kind of use two very different situations. The first being what I'm talking about with this young, beautiful woman, this Israeli student who's been murdered. You know, and obviously, you know, she got off the tram after midnight. And you think in this day and age, like, yeah, women should be able to do whatever they want, whenever they want. And unfortunately, it's just not quite the case. Like, we have to, you know, think more intelligently about protecting ourselves, unfortunately. And it's not a great way of thinking, right? We don't want to be walking around the world in terror, like thinking we could be the next victim or anything like that. But unfortunately, as women in particular, I'm not saying men don't have to do this as well, but we do have to think about this stuff. And unfortunately, you know, this young woman, you know, she felt pretty safe. She wasn't in protection mode. She was having a good time on FaceTime with her sister after midnight, having a great night out with her friends, and was attacked, right? And, you know, that is a case of a horrible tragedy that none of us want to have to think about ever happening to a stranger, let alone somebody close to us or ourselves. But the fact of the matter is, we have to be intelligent about our safety, unfortunately. Like, we kind of have to be a little bit pessimistic, you know, about, like, you know, other people at different times in different situations. We have to just protect ourselves and be intelligent about it. Now, I'm going to contrast this, and I hope I don't offend anybody. I might. Oh, well. But, you know, I'm going to contrast this with a situation that I was in just last night, which is completely different to this, completely. But I was actually having a strategy session with an amazing human being who's a super expert in the realm of, in the area that I work in taking businesses and helping getting that mission clear and all that sort of stuff. And anyway, I was having a conversation with her, and, instantly I noticed like, you know, different things were happening and I couldn't help it, but my defenses were coming up. Like, firstly, I felt a bit disconnected because, you know, she wasn't going to get on video and I was kind of expecting us to jump on video and like build a little bit more rapport and like connect a bit deeper. And anyway, that's just how I kind of work. And, you know, for whatever reason, that didn't happen. And so I was kind of like, ugh. And then, you know, we were straight into it and I was talking into some ideas and stuff and I had it in my mind, like it was only in my mind, I've realized now, but I had it in my mind, I don't want to be pushed in this direction. Like I want to make sure that I'm going in this really inspiring direction. And because I had my defenses up in that context, I was going, like I was kind of getting a bit defensive and a little bit like, I was, you know, friendly, but I was like, oh, I don't know. It was a resistant is a good word for it. And it wasn't until like after that call, I was like, all right, like I think I got a lot of work to do. And luckily I had a recording of the call, which I shared with an amazing human being who I absolutely trust the opinion and judgment of. And they have this real ability to be impartial and see what's really going on, you know, when you kind of get out of it. And so I gave the recording to them and I was like, can you just give me some feedback on this? Was I missing something? Like, I feel like I'm not sure if I was on the right path with this. I just really value your feedback. And when I got their feedback, they were like, okay, here's what I was seeing. And I think it was very different to what you were seeing. And they gave me such perspective, which I'm usually like excellent at, like that's what I do all day. But you know, sometimes when you're in it and you're defensive because something triggers you and you know, I had all this other stuff that's like way deeper than just the fact we didn't get on video. It was a lot to do with my past business and I had all these little triggers and it made me defensive in that context where I could have felt very safe. I'm with somebody who really is committed to my success, right? But I got defensive in that situation versus, you know, and I hate to contrast this because it's of absolutely such low significance compared to what I'm mentioning about this beautiful young woman. But I'm talking about knowing when to have our defenses up and knowing when we really need to be intelligently open, you know, and take our defenses down. And there's definitely times, you know, where, you know, we get this muddled up, you know, this beautiful woman last night, you know, she had her defenses way down when she really needed to be more intelligent about that too. And I'm not condoning, obviously I'm not saying anything about like, oh, she deserved it or anything like that. Like, please do not misinterpret me whatsoever. Because it's a horrific tragedy that should never happen. And I hope for a world where women, men alike, kids could like wander all night and not have any problems. But the fact of the matter is, it's not the case. And we need to be intelligent about it so that we don't lose unnecessary lives. And it's just an unnecessary tragedy. There's different elements that need to be discussed there and probably more so about the kind of person who could conduct that kind of behavior and go down that path, obviously, right? But I want to use that kind of like defenses down when they needed to be up versus my defenses up when they really needed to just be down so I could be open more to that, the value that was being given to me instead of me being like resistant. And, you know, I'm grateful I had that other human being in my life to be able to give me that perspective and remind me of it so that I could truly like see, take my personal feelings out of it, like, cause I got a little bit like in fear and actually just like get the real value out of it and get beyond the fear and learn a bit more about myself and overcome that. But really, in this roundabout way, I'm hoping that this message today just gets you thinking about maybe where are my defenses way up and they're preventing me from depth of connection, they're preventing me from really going and getting and gleaning value from whatever it is, and I'm cutting myself off from opportunity, versus where are my defenses so low that I am, you know, getting victimized. you know, in whatever way that is. Obviously not to the degree that this beautiful woman had to experience, but, you know, sometimes in our lives we have our boundaries way too high and we can't let anybody in, and therefore we can't let any of their value in, versus when we have them totally open and we're just opening ourselves up and welcoming, you know, a perpetrator into our lives of some variety, that's diminishing our self-worth and, you know, our lives in some capacity. So getting your thinking outside the box a little bit about this one. Very, very different examples that I'm giving you. I hope it's still relatable to you. And I definitely, definitely want to check in with you guys and sending you so, so much love to every single one of you guys. I absolutely want to check in and see who's been able to join live. And if you guys aren't currently part of the Limitless Potential monthly masterclasses, what are you doing? On the 26th of January, we've got our next live online training. I am super pumped to deliver this one to you guys and connect with the amazing, amazing community of like minds that you superstars are. And it's all going to be on the neuroscience of personality and how you can discover your unique genius, hone it, and ultimately value yourself, what you have to offer, and deliver it to the world. So I can't wait to definitely dive into that one with you guys. And if you aren't currently part of the masterclasses, the link is up above. If you have any questions whatsoever about being a part of that community, please do let me know. It is so dirt cheap. You guys are, it's a no-brainer, and you get access to all the previous monthly masterclasses. It's literally only $19 US per month. That's it, and you get access to all the best tools, the community, our live trainings, you get everything. So if you want to go deeper, that's how to do it. So I have got Tim and Anthony and Judy and Lucy, hello to you beautiful, and Alexandria, yay, and Rams here as well, and Imran, much love to you, and Sarah, oh my goodness, what a shock for everyone in your neighborhood, so, so sad, sending love. Thank you so much, beautiful Sarah, so appreciate your love and your kindness, and you know what? You know, I've noticed this. This is what happens to me, and this is how my mind works. Every time there is a horrific tragedy, I can't help but notice all the beauty that's going on. Like, I know it's such a horrific situation, but, you know, people like yourself, Sarah, are a great example of that, you know? Spreading that love, you know, sending that love out. You know, there's, you know, a great... you know, there's a whole vigil going on for this beautiful woman. There are flowers being laid out. People are coming together in yet another tragedy here in Melbourne that is just, it's so pointless, so tragic, all the rest of it. But I think that sometimes there is that other side, you know, the duality of everything. There's a positive to every negative. I hate to say it because it rattles some people up when they're just only seeing the negative. But at the end of the day, life is duality. There's always the other side. And when whatever we choose to focus on will become our reality, will become what we're continuously manifesting into the world. It's just a fact. So, you know, I choose to see that, you know, the tragedy, we need to do something about it. You know, we need to do something about the people who perpetrate. And we also need to educate people who are becoming victims. And we also need to recognize that when these tragedies happen, we learn more, we're inspired more to take action and change the rules of the game. And we bring people together and we focus on what matters. So there's always that other side. So thank you for being a beautiful example of that today, Sarah. I so appreciate you being here. And Timalcina, hello to you, or it might be Rajesh, I don't know, but hello, and I love you being here, and John's here as well, and Alexandria, well, sad to hear this horrible news, but shows the reality of living every moment as it may be your last. Absolutely, Alexandria, and you couldn't have put it better, spirit sister, I love it. Yeah, absolutely, you've just highlighted another positive that can come from such tragic events. The reminder, this could be it, you know, particularly when it happened so close to home. Like, the guy who committed this murder was found here in Greensboro where I live, like, you know, and that's a scary thought, you know, to think that somebody who could commit such a heinous crime you know, is in your vicinity. You know, it's scary and it makes it even more real. And that wakes us up and makes us not only be intelligent about keeping ourselves safe, but also, you know, reminds us, like you're saying there, Alexandria, you know, to live each moment like it could be your last, you know, and don't focus on it being your last, but live it fully. And, you know, all that great stuff. So I love that. Beautiful. And Gregory's here, and Julie, and Anantha, hello to you. And Alexandra, always be mindful, aware, and as prepared as possible. You got it, girlfriend. And I'm not somebody who focuses ever on safety sometimes. Like I can get caught out. So I can feel for people who do get caught up and victimized, because I'm like, oh, like, yeah, I do that. And, you know, just a couple of days ago, I had a guy come to my door selling something. And anyway, I kept like the screen door like locked, because my mum is a safety fanatic. So she's drummed it into my mind, like always keep, you know, any screen door locked, you know, you don't know who they are or whatever. And so that was kind of drummed into my mind. But eventually, like when I got a word in and I was able to tell him, oh, you know, sorry, like, you know, not interested or whatever, he asked me for a glass of water. And I was like, oh, I'm going to have to open the door. And so I just went and got him a glass of water and like opened the door and like stood there while he drank this glass of water and stuff. And it was all okay. But, you know, it's just could be a random circumstance like that. If somebody wants to attack you, like they can easily attack you and they can easily prey on people who want to please you. You know, like I'm can definitely fall in that trap. I've had many situations. Even on my trip to Europe, I don't think I've told you guys about a lot of them, but I've had to shake my head at myself and just, you know, be grateful that I'm still alive for making, you know, some poor decisions at times. So it's just a good reminder, I think, for us all. Unfortunately, we need that. So yeah, I love it. And Sarah, I know what you mean. Sometimes I am too relaxed about safety. When you hear something like this, it makes you think. Absolutely, Sarah. So spot on. Unfortunately, you know, we don't really want those living examples of what could happen to us, but sometimes like we need to know what's going on so we can think about it, you know, and use our brains about it and be intelligent with our safety, unfortunately. So I love that. And Moyne's here as well. Hello to you, my friend. And Ram, this incident is really so very tragic. So much needs to be done, so much. You got it, Ram, absolutely. So much horrific stuff happening always, but you know, a lot needs to be done. Instead of worrying about it and getting depressed about it and getting caught up in the tragedy, we need to work out, like, how could we make this system better? What do we need to do? How do we need to educate? Like all those things. And also finding the other side, finding the value and finding the lesson. That's what we need to focus on instead of getting too caught up in the tragedy of it all and just, you know, creating this perception of the world that everybody's bad and, you know, that is not going to be healthy. So we need to think about what will empower us. And not just, you know, be in la-la land about it, but actually be intelligently safe about it. So yes, absolutely, Ram. And Sarah, sometimes I can get perspectives wrong. It's all a learning curve. Absolutely. You got it. And usually, you know, because we see the world, you know, through our thoughts, through our feelings of who we are, through our triggers, through our fears, you know. So that's why we can oftentimes get perspectives wrong. And that's why it's really good to be able to notice within yourself when you can feel your defenses come up, you know, and you're like, okay, all right, I might be getting this wrong because I can feel that I'm in fear here, and then get curious about the situation. Ask the person more questions about what they really mean, or if you're lucky enough to have a recording of a situation and you can give it to somebody you know, like, and trust, that's always helpful too. I love it, Sarah. And Frank, good to see you, my friend. You might have been a little bit late, so I hope you catch a recording, get a ton of value from today's message. I've also got, oh God, I got to run out the door. I'm going out for a bit of a family dinner, so got to go pick some peeps up, got to get all the way over the other side of town, so I better head out. But I'm going to say hi to Shane and Sarah, loving that this was resonating with you. And Craig's here as well. And George, hi Vanessa, hello everyone on here. Y'all are awesome. We are all superstars. Yes, show love, be loved. We all deserve it. George, you're such a superstar. I love having people like you in this beautiful community who are connecting. And, you know, that's part of my mission. Part of what I want to do is create a community of extraordinary like minds who are absolutely reaching for their potential, and they're challenging each other to do the same. So you're such a great example. Thanks, George. And Akko, I'm going to call you Valu because I'm not too sure if it's your first or your last name, but I love having you here. And Sarah, it's very scary and unfortunately could stop you from moving forwards and taking opportunities, because sometimes fear does this. You can end up too defensive too. It's following your instincts, I think. Absolutely, Sarah, you have got it spot on. And I think, you know, if your instincts say no, trust them. Right? You know, it's just not worth risking your life in the physical world. And then when it comes to the environment of just like a relationship dynamics, you know, yep, trust them, but then do the work to work it out and build your emotional intelligence. Get curious, like I said, get different perspectives. It's super valuable. So I love, love, love everything that you guys have contributed today. You're such superstars, and I really appreciate your kindness, your connection, and your words of wisdom shared with us all. So much love for you guys for spending your time. And as always, I'm sending you guys all of my love, light, blessings, gratitude, energy, enthusiasm, everything extraordinary coming to you to wherever you are in the world today. I really do hope that it's beautiful, amazing, and extraordinary, and that you're doing something empowering, and that today's message has just got you thinking outside the box about where you have got your boundaries and defenses way up, where they need to come down a little bit so you can get the value and connection from your outside world, and where you really need to pull them up a bit, because you're going to get victimized emotionally, physically, whatever realm that is. Okay, so be intelligent about keeping yourself safe and protected. And thank you so much, Sarah. Much love to you. That is it from me today, guys. Sending you all of my love, and I cannot wait to see you guys tomorrow.